Hey fellow nerds, look what Nerdo found, a Tyranerds Tyrannofex. This is a brilliant model, and I want to use this video also to thank Kevin, the guy I'm painting a lot of stuff for. This one here, this box, is actually his Christmas present for me, because he's so glad that I'm painting his stuff up. Well, I'm cashing up some money, I must say, but still he is very happy with the results. So, thank you, Kevin, again for this wonderful present, and let's just take a look at this box. So, we have this Tyrannofex we can build from this box, and also we can build a Tervigon / Tervimom, which is breeding some termagants. We can see here from the side her belly and the first termagant getting out. Here the front side, looking very pleased to be born. And then we have another weapon option for the Tyrannofex? Yep, Tyrannofex. So I will unwrap this beauty, and then I will again be back in a second. So, fellow nerds, I've got my trusty codex here at hand, so for once I know what I'm talking about. So let's just dive into this beautiful box. So, okay, we've got some sprues in here. Wow, these weapons are really massive. Let's put this aside and just take a look at the sprues. 1, 2, 3. Okay, there we go with a base and with the assembly instruction. Okay, let's flick through the assembly instruction first. Read before assembly, yala yala. Okay, there we go. We've got one main body, obviously, which goes for both versions of this kit. Right, body and legs assembled. No, that's actually the Tyrannofex. Where is the Tervimom? Okay, here. We've got a difference in the belly there. Okay, this is actually also glued over the main body. We can see here. This is glued over the main body. So yes, we do have one start for both options. And then if you choose to go for the Tervigon, you just glue these belly parts over the existing chest piece, I would say. If not, if you're going for the Tyrannofex, then you would keep this chest piece there. So there we go. That's pretty interesting, to be honest. Never done something like that, like gluing parts over parts which are actually perfectly perfect. So there we go with the base, and now for the options here. Okay, let's push the codex aside and generate some place to show this beauty off. Now, let's talk about the two options. We've got the Tervigon as an option, which comes at 225 points, with some options to increase the points by giving him more equipment. And we've got the Tyrannofex, which starts with 181 points. And we can upgrade that with our weapons and gear. So it's about 200 plus points there in the box, a bit more than 200, I would say. So let's take a little look at the sprues. Okay, our trusty assembly again. Okay, there we go. This is those are some sacks for the weapon options. And which we have here. Option A is the acid spray. Okay, let's watch. Okay, here, this is one part of the acid spray gun. It should come with three parts. Second one should be somewhere near, to be honest. I don't know where it is. Oh, look at this guy. This is actually the terminal coming out of the Tervimom. Okay, this is the second part of the acid spray, and there's the middle part. And after that, just glue one of those arms with the sacks on there. With the sacks of goodness! A lot of acids or a lot of other little crawling bugs. Then we've got, I think, the rupture cannon here, coming also in two parts. And then, yeah, this is then the arm, the other arm for the rupture cannon. And then we've got the flesh borer hives, which are actually attached to the side of the creature, as we can see here, right under the legs. And that would be this here. It's like kind of a grenade launcher, launching the flesh borers into your enemy. That's something nice that will get under their skin very soon. Does the Terry Mom have any weapon options? I don't think so. I think it's just the Terry Mom without any additional guns. Yeah. The only thing is there's this wonderful little guy here, this one, which is just lurking and looking out of his mummy's belly, like kangaroo-like, something like that. No, that's very nice, man. Okay, we've got here the belly parts, we've got the back of the whole monster, we've got those sacks full of termagants, brooding in an amazing speed, and there we have some legs, some scything or scything talons, however that is pronounced. Oh, and those are the both parts for the flesh borer hive. That's the arm actually, and here on this side, which is pretty flat, yeah, on here you would just glue those two parts. There's the second one. Well, more talons. Interesting thing, what's this actually? Wow, I don't know what this is, but I'm eager to find out when I build this model myself. We've got some Mr. Krabs going on here. And a head. Are there actually, yes, there are two, at least two head options, unless I missed something. I don't think this is a head option. I think this is a head option for something else crawling out of her belly. And then we've got some little bits like this one. I think these are the toxin sacs, but I'm not very sure. Here's the second one, or a second one. Or no, this could be adrenaline glands, and this could be the toxin sacs. Right, here we go. Okay, there's a lot of interesting stuff going on. Some more bits, I'm unable to tell you what these things are, but I'm finding out more awesomeness each and every day. I'm flipping through the codex or just watching videos or making videos myself. So this is, or this was, the unboxing of the glorious Tyrannofex / Tervigon. Thank you again, Kevin, for this wonderful present. I just can't wait to throw it back into your face. Well, once when we can make a date for a game. So, ladies and gents, I would like to thank you for watching this video. I'm just pushing them out at the moment. If you would like to see more of those Tyranerds stuffs or Tyranid stuff, please just subscribe and hit the bell button so you can join me on my voyage into Warhammer 40k and in my voyage on building a Warhammer 40k army, the Tyranids, the Swarm. So thank you very much again, and see you next time. Bye!